What's going on? All right, so I'm back here at the Warrior. You guys wanted it, so I'm back here again, giving you another track preview. So right here, we're starting at the hole shot. We're in Greensboro, PA, if anybody's interested to know where we're at. MEXE. So you got the hole shot, come around here. Couple little swoops. Wonder why they ever put these swoops in here, for slow everybody down before they go in the woods, or always wondered that. A couple turns. So all right, I'm back out here on my 125, and if you raced this track before, it's a great track to run. I like it, except when it's muddy. So here we're on this first straight right here into the woods. It's always good. Oh dear, man, you see that? This section always gets wet out. So, alright, so we got some water. Already some standing water. But the track itself looks really nice. Hopefully that rain holds off. Right there at the beginning looked like a little split section right here. Check that out. We got some mud. Got outside, inside right here in this turn. I've raced this track mostly in dusty conditions. One time it rained about three quarters of the way through it, and I got stuck up on the hillside. Talk to Seth. It's about an 8-mile track. Oh, this is my jumping off. That's a little dangerous section. I think that was pretty good. I've seen people bounce off of it. Looks like I'm going to the right instead of the left. Oh no, this is, oh wait, sorry. This is youth track. So you guys will come here to the right. Turn around. Oh, look at that, already got to work. Oh no. Short legs. Sucks. Alright. So youth will go that way. Adults will go this way. Stand uphill. The rain bypasses us, hopefully no rain. But it seems like that's what this year's gonna be about. The rain. Up a little hill, some switchbacks. Yeah, this dirt right now is perfect. Thursday evening, little ride, see a lot of animals. Saw a deer, See a bunch of squirrels, chipmunks. It's not even into my first mod yet. Man, how was last weekend? Wow. God dang. I tell you what, riding that quad mud is fine, but it just got so chaotic. The ruts got so deep. I mean, it was just nasty as hell. But alright, so we got this little tight section up here on top of the ridge. I don't remember everything. I think we're at the 1 mile mark. Oh yeah, here's the old something or other. Oh, beer cans in there. It's a party spot. So when you hit that, you just maybe want the about the 1 mile mark. Here we got some a little mud, a little wetness. Nothing bad. You know me, I don't like the mud. So I had to come out Thursday for you guys because my daughter's wedding. She wasn't letting me go anywhere tomorrow or Friday or Saturday. So I'm going to have to miss Saturday, like I said, filming. I'm sorry. But it's going to be one of the only times this weekend or this year that I got something going on. All right, so we got going uphill. I should be out on Sunday filming the bikes and may race. Depends what it's like. So, I am around that little hairpin up on top of the ridge, it looks like. Coming through some mud sections. Well, I shouldn't say muds, I should say a little wet spot. Not even that slippery, but here we go. Yeah, got some mud. A little bit of mud. You can avoid it if you want to go outside here. Some kids look like they avoid, or some people look like they avoid mud. I shouldn't say some kids, but I should say about everybody. And then there's some riders that look like they don't care what the hell was in front of them. They just die, oh, this mud. They come back looking like, you know, you can't even tell who they are. They always find a mud hole, that seems like. Alright, so we get out there, still up top. Beautiful out here. Love the scenery, the times keeps growing up. So it's getting harder to see out in front of you. Oh yeah, I remember a couple years ago, this section I think up here got really nasty. Oh, squirrel. So, yeah. I think it was that section back there. It's like the sun never really hits it so it doesn't dry up like this down. This is nice and dry, you know. Ooh, they had to cut the tree down. So we're gonna be dropping off the ridge downhill. Looks like some freshly cut sections. Never always looks the same after a race. Alright, so be careful here. Got a little turn. Going downhill still. Little sweepers. Into a little off camber section. Danger. Oh, got a little jump. Yeah, you don't want to hit that too hard because you got a real sharp turn. So be careful right there. It's in between the one and the two, maybe. I haven't paid attention. Maybe I need to pay attention. Maybe he hasn't put the mile mark. I think that last one was a written one. But like I said, I came out early just so I could get this guy, so I could get this video to you guys. That was my main purpose. Little, power line section coming in. Oh yeah, that's always nice. Uphill. Mm-hmm. whoa, front end almost washed up. So now you hit the 2 mile mark. Alright, so what do we got over here? Got some fresh cut, looks good. Alright, got a fresh turn maybe right here. Set the track's really nice right now. I hate doing these video reports and give you guys one thing and then the next. Alright, so now we're dropping through this power line, tree stand, not tree stand, but a blind. So we're coming down. Some switchbacks. Slows you guys up. That's probably why the Paris guys are, we're all not just flying into the woods at one time. Alright, so we got maybe a quarter mile little field section right here. Into the woods. On a beautiful Thursday evening. Couldn't ask for a better evening after work. Fun little set. That was fun. Whoa, watch that tree. Man. Ah, man. Alright. Maybe I should wear long sleeve shirts, but yeah. Alright, let's get back on it. So we just passed the 2 mile mark, right? Is that what I said? In this little fresh maybe cut section. Grown up in last year. Up back up the hill. Alright, remember, if you guys like these videos, make sure you hit the thumbs up on YouTube. Comment, you know. I come out here to bring this to you guys. I don't get paid for this crap. But it's nice for Ronnie and Seth to let me come out and bring this to you guys. At least get a day in riding. Whoa. Come out here every Saturday, Sunday, praying for a little dryness, and you know, you get a ride by. Some people are lucky, got some property, they can ride all week. Some people have to wait for the weekend, but you know, it's nice that NEXC and some of these other guys, they put on these things for us to come out and have a place to run. 2 hours of racing, let me tell you, you can do it. anybody can come out and ride for 2 hours like this. Like I said, I can ride all day. But to have some speed and everything else, yeah, good luck. This will even make the strongest guys whimper. Cool, a little up and down sets, little sweepers. Got some old section here, obviously from the leaves on the ground. Like I said, this is a great track. Ooh, got a little jump. Woo! Just be careful, you got trees right there. Alright, so we're hitting the 3 mile mark. Go cut through here. Yeah, I'm not out here to make lines or anything. I'm just out here to show you guys. Except this one. It's my private line right here. Nobody take it. Alright, so we just came back up. Probably about midway on the hillside, I would say. Looks like we're starting to make our way back down. Switchbacks. Switchbacks are good because it obviously adds some distance to the track. A lot of times it's different variables from just 50 yards up there to down here. It can be real smooth up there and rocky down here. But this track is really not a rocky track. It's a real nice track if it stays the way it should. Hopefully stays. I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying what I've seen just doesn't look pleasant. But all right, so I'm gonna sweep around. Cool little section here. Uh-oh. Well, uphill. That's after we're in the 3 mile mark. Another little jump. I don't think I would hit that very hard. So we're coming up here. Where are we going? All right, left hander. Little S turns down, sweeping down. Not sure how many acres this property is. Who exactly owns it, but thanks for having us. Let us come out here and run some miles on your property. Water hole. Not too many water holes up top. Just down here. A hard right, left hand turn. Left-hander down. There's a section right here, you guys. You need to make a pass, let somebody pass. As some of these tracks get start growing up, it's harder and harder for a lot of sections to let people pass will pass somebody because of the drone. You know, like right here and stuff, you know, you're kind of just going to have to hold your line, especially on a quad. You might be able to pull over here, but it gets a little tight. I think this might be the only little... I got my tracks mixed up today talking to Seth. I thought this had the big rock section, but that was the gold rush in there. So, yeah, but I think this is like the only little rock section right back here in this tight little cut to the side of the hill. And it's not even big rocks, it's just little rocks. So they'll eventually get topped out once the quads go over them. Like that, gotta watch out for that rock. Alright, now we should get down into a field section. A little crossover. Yeah. Alright, here we go. Now see, some of those the old tracks. So it looks like he's got some new stuff this year. This might be an old section, I remember. But like I said, it's a fun track. You've never ridden it. And guys like the mud race, it's a good track to run at. Well, eventually it will test your mud skills. This is PA mud. Alright, so alright, we jump back on with the kitties. Right here by the pole. So anybody up to races trying to get out to certain areas, you can get through those little roadways. So once you hit the 4 mile mark, we drop in. The pro was working. Shut off at me on a power line. About 6.5-7 miles, but it was still on, but I don't know why it stopped recording. Alright, so we're in the 4 mile section. Little turnies. I like this side over here. I've done buddy races out here. Let's see, I guess we're going this. So micros are going to go right there, and youth and adults still come this way. Sorry, micros. Continue on. This looks like some fresh section. Now, when I'm saying fresh, you might have ridden them a year or two ago. Otherwise, I ain't doing it anymore. Beautiful forest, woods, whatever you want to call them. Ride some bikes. So this time I'm going to be able to get this video out to you guys earlier. So you have a chance to watch it. I'd like to get a four stroke, but I do hate this kind of two strokes. Alright, so still on the 4 mile mark, coming up through into a field section. To the top. Oh, that's about where I got stuck a couple years ago, man. This section in here got muddy and my bike was just stuck with mud. If anybody remembers, I forget, I was laying like maybe over in here or wherever the track might have been, but yeah, I looked like I was about half dead. I felt like I was about half dead. A little downhill. Right hand turn. Woo. Easy. Getting too excited. All right, coming down here. Make a right hand turn. Past the dead tree. Cool little section. Can't wait for the blackberries to start coming out of the black raspberries. Anybody want to pick me a couple gallons? Alright, so, a little jump right here. Woo! Be careful because you're into a turn. Wrong way. Oh! I see single track, Seth. You have a single track section going for the bikes? Single track section going. We're not gonna film that. Gotta leave something to the imagination for the bike riders. So if it does have a single section, then that's awesome. So the quad guys can stay with me for now. But I thought I saw some black and orange arrows, which normally indicates a single bike section. So. Alright, coming down here for the... And then you never know, if it gets real bad, you may not even want it. So, stay with me. Continue the ride. The waitress will be around to take your order. Oh, I love the smell too. It's just... That smell when I used to come from California back here, it was just such a different smell. It's like so fresh, you know. You can actually breathe. Alright, so we got a little uphill. I don't know if I've seen the 5 mile mark while I was talking or not, but The single track probably should come out around here somewhere. Maybe. Oh, yeah. I'll tell you what, this track is going to be prime, man. Like I said, nice track, fun, smooth. Smells good. It's a good smelling track. You're not smelling the cow shit, you know. Stuff like that. Ooh, watch your head. Got a little dropper. Got a little drop tree across the track. I don't know what that was. That was pretty. That'd be a big squirrel. Alright, so, going down. Oh yeah, I know this section, a little open field section, or, I don't know what you call it, just a little open dirt section. Almost looks like it was a gas well or something, maybe at one time, or, it's got a lot of coal, I don't know, maybe a strip mine, maybe it's a strip mine area. I'm not sure on this property. Alright, so what we got here? Little downhill creek, something or other. Six mile mark could get different some ruts. Probably some roots are going to start showing a lot of these sections. Back into the more shaded side of the track. A little bit softer. Slipperier. Oh yeah, the 125 wants to go, man. Aren't you rid of the baby? Oh, I got a little jumper here. Just got a nice track going on. They got a nice section. I like this section over here. Ooh, there's a bird. Alright, so now we're gonna hit a field. Big ass tree. It's probably been there a long time. Little field section. Is that a pool over there? Dang, look like a pool over there. Need to go jump in. Alright, so we cross over and into here, a little outside, it's actually dusty right here. Section. Not too bad right now. Got kind of a rock base in that. Just be careful, that's after the 6 mile mark. Looks like some fresh cut up here. Little turns. Alright, so the micros jumped back on here for the last probably mile and a half. Good little section. Last year coming up this section was always fun. Never gonna be going down it. But look at the sand. This dirt is just perfect. Probably wouldn't be too dusty. But like I said, Mother Nature just has nasty attitude this year. I don't know what's going on with her. just pissed at the racing world of cross-country racing. You know, rain what you want to on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and then, you know, lighten up. Should be coming down to the bottom, making a right turn. And like I said, this shit's dusty right here. And then you got your low spots that have the water. Let's go through it right now to see. Nothing too bad. Your hay starting to grow. Hay they lose putting these tracks in. You have to pay for the hay dinner too. Alright, so normally, normally we go, we go down here first, then we jump back. Okay. Find a little new section. Here, if it's dusty, go into this is cool. Another edge. where that, yeah, there's that overhang. Watch the marker up here. Ah, my ass got wet. Damn it. Yeah, this little tin right here. Use it for siding in. To the fields, and then I think it come down. Doors are finished. So like I said, man, if you guys enjoy these things, make sure you keep telling us that you'd like to see them, and I'll keep coming out here and doing them. Like I said, it gives a good chance for everybody to see the track, and it's hard to get out and walk these tracks or ride the tracks. Everybody gets here the day of the race and then just races them. And, but you got a lot of different variants and it changes up from year to year. So it's nice to get out here and check it out. So make sure you guys hit the thumb button, subscribe, share this video, watch it 50 million times, get the track down. Like I said, thanks to Bonnie and Seth for coming, letting me come out here and do this early. Come through the finish, and here they are, relaxed, no problems until Saturday. Say, Sandy. All right, so we come out of the finish line, and then obviously we'll come back in and connect back in to go into the woods. Come back in right here to jump back onto the track, it looks like. But yeah, everybody, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and please, like I said, subscribe, share this video, hit the like button on YouTube, which helps the channel grow, and then you'll go right back into there. So that was one lap here at the Warrior. Hope you guys enjoyed. Hope it looks like this Saturday and Sunday. And wish I could be here on Sunday, Saturday, but like I said, Colby Landon's wedding, so